Well, hello everyone, I'm Yanni from VU Gaming, and today we're back in Milkmaid of the Milky Way. So, something woke us up here. Let's go and look around and see if we can find something out. And let's check on the cows and see how they are doing. Oh no, a fear grew in me, a Daxter. Lyca was missing, I needed to find her. Oh no, we're missing one of the cows, that's not good. The cow was waking, visibly shaking. She was luckily resting, leaving her would be the best thing. My pulse raced upwards steeply, but the cow was merely sleeping deeply. Okay, so they are all okay, but we still have to find Lyca. So let's just look around a little bit and see. It doesn't seem like there's anything over here that's gonna tell us anything at all. Okay, well, maybe. Gonna have to go up in the mountain and see if there is anything to find up here. Maybe she got startled by a storm or something. Oh, look at that beautiful sky up here. Oh, nice. Oh, what is that? I think we're gonna try and go this way. And see if we can find something. Oh, it's glittering. And what is this? I looked down, guess what I found? Lyca's cowbell on the ground. Oh no. Lyca's bell I'd found, it made a jangly sound. A light seemed to radiate from the salty rock slate. It gave me a feeling I couldn't define. A chill went down my spine. Okay. Can we do something with it? The rock was solid and hard. It couldn't be mud. Okay, so I don't think we can do anything with this. Okay. Can we do something with the butter? No. Okay, well, I don't think we can do anything with that, so... Huh. Let's try and look around over here. Not quite sure what we are supposed to be doing with that. Oh, no. Oh, there she is. Oh, she's being pulled away. Lyca was stuck, she couldn't get out. My voice was weak, I tried to shout. Oh no, that's not good. I felt helpless, so much at stake. Lyca was trapped in the ice-cold lake. Okay, how are we supposed to help her here? Even if I could hold my breath, the cold water would be a certain death. I shook the bell and hoped she'd hear, but Lyca probably had water in her ear. I'm not quite sure what we're... Yeah, that's a tether. Okay, I don't really know. Cool water from the water wide, dropping down the mountainside. If I went back down, Lyca would surely drown. Okay, well, we have a spoon. No offense, but that made no sense. No need to try, that would go awry. Awry, I guess. Okay, I am not quite sure. I banged the bell with great tension. It seemed to work, it got her attention. This was working, I could tell. Lyca was hearing me banging the bell. A little more and she would make it ashore. Nice, we got it, yay! There, there, I said to us both, I'll always take care of you, that is my oath. Yay, that's good, we saved her. I was getting all scared there. Okay, nice. After a sleepless night, I led the cows to graze. It felt good to feel the sun in my face. Today I had to clean out the manure. These were the things a farmer must endure. Okay, well, then we're gonna have to go back down. And get our chores done. While the cows are out grazing. Go. Oh no. What now? Wow, okay, I didn't expect that. Yeah, I would make that face too if it was me. The thunderous sound, the heat you could feel, apparition so strange it could make you kneel. Was it a dream? No, it was real. Don't steal my cows. Oh boy. Oh no, what now? The thunderous steam and gas made it impossible to pass. I let out a sigh that wasn't even worth a try. No. Well then, how are we supposed to... My mind blank, I was glued to my feet. It was like looking into a furnace of blue intense heat. Yeah. I was just trying something. Okay. Well, we don't really have much we can work with here. I felt dense, that didn't make any sense. No. The cows looked confused and scared, poor things. What was this terrible machine with wings? Oh no! They're stealing my cows! They took my cows, lifted them through the air. My jaw dropped, my eyes a thousand-yard stare. They stole my cows! What? Suddenly the ship took off with a hiss. Hey, you're not getting away with this. Okay. The ship was maneuvering just beneath. My heart was pounding, I grit my teeth. If I built momentum, could I jump aboard? I'd have to time it right or I'd end up in the fjord. Oh boy. Nope. If I built momentum... my timing was wrong, I couldn't jump that long. Okay. So, kind of have to wait until it gets closer, right? So... Come on. Time to commit. I went for it. Ooh. Oh, wow. Ouch. Hang on. Wow. My head was hurting, truth to be told, but at least I'd found my foothold. Now that I hadn't died, I had to find a way inside. Oh, wow. Okay. Looks like there might be something up here, maybe? What are these things? These won't budge, I said with a grudge. Okay, can we get up there? The huge dome glistened in the sun. I looked for windows, but found none. All were closed, no handles exposed. Okay, what if we go this way? Can we go this way? Okay, can I use this maybe? That didn't seem right. That hatch was sealed tight. Okay, what if we use the butter on it? I didn't want to leave butter on the floor. I decided to carry it around a bit more. Okay, I was thinking maybe we could loosen something with it. Oh, now you let me go over here. The ship was built by metal somehow. It sloped smoothly towards the bow. Yep. But it doesn't seem like we can go anywhere. I bit my lip. There was nowhere to put that on the ship. Okay, well, so that's not what we want to do. How are we supposed to get up there? What about this thing? No? Oh, there we go. Okay. Well, it doesn't really... I couldn't walk out there. Hot steam was everywhere. Well... What is this? It was a strange looking panel with holes. There didn't seem to be any controls. Can we put this in there somehow? There was no plan, I wasn't being clever, but maybe the spoon could be used as a lever. The spoon stuck out a bit, but otherwise it was a perfect fit. Oh! It seemed the lever was used to obstruct the steam coming from the duct. Nice. Okay, let's try and go over here. I bent down to investigate. It was a very hot metal plate. Can I use the butter now? It's gonna melt. The butter went from a thick, hard piece to a melted oil, a pool of grease. Okay. I could feel the heat from where I stood, like a furnace burning forests, just not wood. Not just wood. Okay. So now we have melted butter. How's that gonna... I'm not sure how that's gonna help us. But let's try and go back up again. It slopes smoothly towards the bow. Okay, can I use this over there somehow? Nope. That was a smooth metal plate which I couldn't lubricate. Okay. Can I do something up here? I tried to no success. I'd have to give it another guess. Yeah, that's just it. I'm guessing. Okay, well, I'm not really... Oh, maybe we can go something over here. It didn't seem like we could go this way, but let's just try. No? Okay. Okay, so after puzzling around a little bit here and running all over the place and not being able to figure out where I'm supposed to use this butter or get inside, I ended up looking it up online, and it turns out there's a difference in what you click on here. So if we click on this one, it says all were closed, no handles exposed. So I kind of assumed that everything was closed, but that's not actually the case, because if you click on this one, that hatch had a small gap on one side, but still it was stuck no matter how I pried. I just wish this one hadn't said that all was closed, because then you kind of, you know, think it counts for all of them. But it doesn't. So let's see if we can get this butter to work now. Maybe the melted butter would grease the edges of this metal piece. The butter filled the edges and disappeared. That was my last chance, I feared. The hatch would still not budge. Maybe if I... Fudge! Oh boy, okay, well, we made it inside. Ouch, ouch, ouch. I had bruised my lip but was inside the ship. Okay, can we go this way? Is there anything here? It was dark down that way. My eyes were used to the light of day. Okay, it doesn't seem like we can go that way, so let's try and go the other way. What is this? There was a sheet or panel that I couldn't dismantle. I felt fear. I heard footsteps near. Oh no, what's that? Oh, okay. The old man spoke in a strange tongue, his voice and face far from young. Instead of trying to understand, I turned away and ran from the man. Oh boy, well then someone else just came along. The queen-like figure stared with eyes so tense, she spoke in a language that made no sense. I told her quite frankly, I don't understand. Your words must derive from a faraway land. I think in that moment we both understood. Speaking like this would do us no good. Okay. The words sounded strange, but now they made sense. She asked me my name, her voice slightly tense. I told her the truth, my name is Ruth. Ruth, she said, her eyes narrow, it sent a tremor through my marrow. This is the Veda. Welcome aboard. You managed to get here of your own accord. I'm Amrita, call me impressed. Getting on board must have been quite a quest. What can I say? I faced my fear. I couldn't just stay and see my cows disappear. This youthful irreverence, I find it refreshing. This might all have been a blessing. I needed to ask, where are my cows and why did you take them? Your questions are many, I'm sure. Let me rather give you a tour. Come, she said, and gestured me to follow. Down the corridor, our footsteps sounded hollow. Ooh, okay. That kind of looks like that piece of salt. Welcome to the Veda. Come with me. There is much to show and much to see. Oh, you want to go this way. What is this thing? Oh, okay. Too late. Oh. Okay. This is the biodome, our holy retreat. Here the animals sleep and eat. The dome was filled with air and light. It truly was a magnificent sight. This is the high point of our tour. As you can see, your cows are secure. What did you do to my head? Would you warn just before I said? The brief pain notwithstanding, it gave you the gift of understanding. All I could say, what are they? Once the milk beasts were plentiful and diverse, now these are the last four in the universe. Amrita's head hung low. Woe, the last bull died eons ago. As I asked, my heart nearly skipped a beat. Are my cows merely food for your beasts to eat? Amrita laughed. Milk beasts are herbivores. They are peaceful and only eat grass, of course. I must see your cows. I got word from our herdsman. He sells their wonderful, quite the specimen. I let out a huge breath of relief. They hadn't ended up as ground beef. This is Pal, our expert in bovine. He says your cows are divine. His voice was old, I must admit. These are beautiful, a perfect fit. A perfect fit, you say? For what, if I may? For the sacrifice, of course, he said without remorse. What sacrifice? Tell me now and no lies. Girl, please stop your crying. You see, our breed is slowly dying. Through vision blurred, I heard, only your cows can save our herd. My heart sank like a stone. You kill my cows to save your own. Not kill per se, but a sacrifice must be made, I'm sorry to say. What does this sacrifice comprise, and why does it lead to my cow's demise? I understand what I'm saying is bold. We transfer youth from the young to the old. To believe it must be seen, let me show you the age machine. A voice was proud, she said, Ruth, this is the machine that regains lost youth. Your cows will save our holy herd when we have their age transferred. Why do you need my cows for this? It felt like being swallowed by an abyss. A trade must be made for aging to reverse. These are the laws of the universe. Matter for matter, they must be the same. Age is an ember, but youth is a flame. Please, there must be some other way. I will do anything, anything you say. Amrita's lips curled. Anything, girl. Let's not stay and chat. See that circle, step into that. Do we really want to do that? Well, looks like we're gonna have to now. The circle to the right, it's in your line of sight. Oh no, are we gonna get old now? I asked her what she wanted. She scowled like she was taunted. She said with badly hidden aggression, give me your most valuable possession. I don't have much to give. I've got my things where I live. In an unexpected rage, she cried, give me your age. Oh no! Bones bent, skin crawled, heart pounding, my mind appalled. Oh no! Look at that! Oh, this is not good.